Everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Skills to Scale. Listen Mahabharat in simple English by Shruti Bhushan. We have seen the sacrifice of Ekalavya. Duryodhana blames Arjuna for the injustice happened to Ekalavya. Guilt-ridden Arjuna decides to know the reason. If you haven't watched the previous video, please watch it. And also like, share and subscribe to Skills to Scale to get more videos. Duryodhana and his brothers blame Arjuna for making Guru Drona do all this. They tell Ashwatthama that his father is being partial to Arjuna. Listening all this, Arjuna goes to his Guru to ask him the reason. On seeing the guilt-ridden Arjuna coming towards him, Guru Drona understands what was going through him. He simply tells Arjuna that whatever he did wasn't because he wanted Arjuna to be the best archer, but because Ekalavya belongs to Magad kingdom. There was a chance that Ekalavya may use his powers and teachings against Hastinapur, as Hastinapur and Magad were enemies. Hearing this, Arjuna gives his guru's blessings and leaves the place. One day, Dronacharya was teaching his students some skills and they see a boy approaching them. He was Karna. We know that Karna left Hastinapur in order to get skills and archery. He approaches many teachers and asks them to teach him archery skills, and all of them reject Karna because he was not a Kshatriya. He finally comes to Dronacharya and requests him. To this, Dronacharya says that he is bound to only teach the princes. He also says that other than Kshatriyas, no one else are allowed to learn archery war skills. To this, Karna and oath that he will definitely get educated in archery and he will become the best archer. Thus saying, he leaves the place. He goes to Parshuram and requests him to teach him archery skills. On asking his identity, he tells him that he is a Brahmin. He decides not to reveal his true identity because no one was accepting him with his true identity. If at all he wanted to learn archery, he had to lie about his identity. Parshuram accepts Karna as his student and he starts teaching him. After so many years, all the Pandavas and Kauravas are about to complete their education. Only few days were left. Karna also excels in his archery and he becomes favorite to Parshurama. One day, Parshurama was sleeping on the floor. Seeing this, Karna requested him to sleep on his lap. Karna takes Parshurama's head and steadily places it on his lap. When Parshurama was in sound sleep, he sees a scorpion crawling towards them. It slowly started biting and drinking Karna's blood. Karna couldn't move because he couldn't disturb his teacher's sleep. He simply sits there bearing the pain. Parshurama feels blood next to his shoulder and shocks upon seeing scorpion biting Karna. Parshurama thinks that a Brahmin cannot bear this much pain. This bearing capacity can only be in Kshatriyas. He asks Karna to reveal his true identity. Karna apologizes and reveals himself to be a son of a charioteer. He also tried to explain why he did this, but Parshurama doesn't listen to him because he wasn't true about his identity. He gets wild and curses Karna that he will lose all his skills at a time when he wants them the most. Thus saying so, Parshurama leaves the place. Karna also leaves for Hastinapur with a heavy heart. The teachings of Kauravas and Pandavas are completed and they were also ready to leave their Gurukul. The news that Kauravas and Pandavas have completed their education reaches Hastinapur. Shakuni plans to use this occasion and make Duryodhana the king of Hastinapur. What plan did Shakuni actually make? Did he succeed in making Duryodhana the king of Hastinapur? To know what was the reason, please watch my next video. If you liked the story and felt it interesting, click on the like button. Do share to your friends and let them know about Mahabharat. Do subscribe for more videos.